Berukhim Abayim, Moshe Lanyaro speaking under the auspices of Kolel Ahavat Yisrael. May they work, spread throughout America, throughout Eretz Yisrael, throughout the world. Kol Ashoneh Halachot B'chol Yom Muftach Lo Shehu Ben Olam Haba. In this week's Parsha, Parshat Shemot, we read about two great women. Women who took it upon themselves to help Jewish mothers give birth and take care of their children, Shifra and Pua. Shifra seemingly was the one in charge of the actual delivery, while Pua took care of the child after he was born. They worked in tandem together. Now, we have an interesting custom or concept which takes place today, that besides the doctor, besides the midwife, we have a doula, a woman who is like a coach for the mother who is in labor. The question arises, of course, the Mishnah tells us, the halakha states clearly that the midwife, the doctor, are mechalel Shabbat to do everything needed for this woman in labor. The question is, what about the doula? What about the assistant? If she's a Jewish woman, can she also come to delivery? She's not the primary doctor. She's just secondary. Does she also have the right to be mechalel Shabbat? And maybe we could bring a halakha from the Gemara in Shabbat. If we have a woman who's giving birth, we are allowed to light a fire for her, turn on the light for her. And the Gemara asks the questions. That is simple. But what happens if the woman asks us to turn on the light and she's blind? And the Gemara tells us that even though she's blind, we can go and turn on the light. Oh, but she doesn't use the light. But it'll make her at ease that other people have light to be able to help her. Such states the Gemara brought down in Halacha. So we see that even though the act is not one of pikuach nefesh, of saving a life, but it's just to put the person at ease, that itself is sufficient. So therefore, if the doula will put this woman at ease, if her mother will put her at ease, her husband will put her at ease, so therefore they have the ability and the right to be mechalel Shabbat, to be with their daughter, their wife, at the birth, to be able to calm her. That's an interesting halacha. But we can ask a question. Rabbi, didn't you just tell me you could turn on the light on Shabbat for a blind woman? She doesn't know the difference if there's light on or not. Just tell her the light's on and she won't know. And maybe we could answer with a beautiful idea. There is the concept of Shabbat, it's true. But there's also the concept of what? Lying. Midavar sheker tirchak. Who says it's allowed to lie to her and tell her the light is on? Maybe it's better to turn on the light and not light her. Rabotai, we take our words for granted. And it's so easy for some people to lie and to say things which are not so true. Let us realize that God gave us the power of speech, to speak Devarim Shel Kedusha, to speak Emet, to speak Divrei Torah. And I'm sure that if we are all so careful and only speak words of truth and kindness, the Geulah will certainly come very soon. Shabbat Shalom.